pretty much in the limelight.
Is it?
Yeah,
I'm
in the
He's got the right kind of car, but he doesn't look like your regular postman.
What's your mate, mate?
That explains why he was sneaking around the houses. But it doesn't explain the issues Fitchy's got with his car.
Whose insurance are you using to drive this for your delivery?
Just the European is going to be able to get that information.
So Royal Mail doesn't cover you?
But yeah, they didn't use the car, so yeah, so...
No, I'm saying that they don't insure you.
But in the eyes of the law, any driver using their own car for work purposes must have the appropriate insurance. And Fitchy's discovered an issue with his driving licence.
You've got an expired driving entitlement. Last update in 97, which means somebody's been trying to contact you properly and you haven't been responding to the communication. Did you ever drink drive or something back then?
No, I lost the licence for 6 months and then...
Never reapplied for it?
Well, that one didn't do it, so.
Every banned driver must surrender their licence to the BVLA. They are reissued with a new one once the ban has ended. Remarkably, this fella's been driving illegally for over 13 years, so Fitchy wastes no time spelling out the letter of the law.
Right, so in other words, the court told you to surrender your licence and you didn't bother to do it.
But can I just explain what happened there?
Well, is that what happened? Did the court tell you to surrender your licence
yes,
and you failed to do it?
Yes, I lost my
licence. Then you found it?
Right,
then
I found it when
right.
I moved.
So you haven't got an entitlement to drive at the moment, so I'm going to be seizing the vehicle under Road Traffic Act. We'll report you for driving otherwise in accordance with a licence. Must caution you, you don't have to say anything. May harm your defence if you don't mention now something later, rely on court. Anything you do say may give them evidence. If I can have the ignition key, you can keep the other keys that are on there. He basically lost his licence and he's kept hold of the card. Some people do that. Not suggesting he has, but some people do. Because they like to have a licence to produce when they get stopped by the police, especially if they're disqualified. Might be what happened in this case. Either way, it suddenly turned up and he still failed to return it.
Meanwhile, Penny's got some news about his insurance.
It appears he does have a policy current at the moment, but it doesn't appear that he's got any business coverage on his insurance.
As well as not covering him for work, his insurance is technically invalid as he's got an expired licence. With a clear-cut case for a seizure, for once Penny's excited about the paperwork.
Oh, can we stick this on?
Certainly. Yeah.
Is this what we now stick on cars when we found that they don't have any insurance? Just to alert other people, obviously, not to drive without any insurance.
It's left to Fitchy to deliver the bad news.
So basically, you're going to get reported for driving without a licence. No insurance and no MOT.
For the cops, the message is signed, sealed and delivered.
Okay, if you want to grab whatever you need out of it, your kiddie seat or whatever.
With his car about to be seized, this postie now has a stack of mail to deliver. On foot. He was later stamped with a £350 fine and 6 points for driving on an expired licence with no insurance. But as usual, the interceptors delivered a first-class service. It's a wet afternoon near Darford, and the interceptors are sat up on the Essex side of the Thames Crossing. Biggers is parked up in the team's Ford Mondeo ST, whilst PC Andy Donaghy is on radio and reflexology duties.
Oh, that was beautiful, that was. Well, my neck was hurting. Yeah, it must be cracking.
Sounded like crack. Yeah, received. We'll see you next.
The boys have received word that a black Alfa Romeo has just come into Essex, and it could be being driven by a disqualified driver.
And I'm ready for it. There's that Alfa. Looks like a male driver.
Play up the orange car for him.
The interceptors decide to intercept.
There's two information reports on the vehicle suggest that it's been driven by